Well, thanks for talking to us, Jeff. An incredible season for the Dundee Stars.
Yeah, obviously, no one likes to lose their last game, and the only way you don't do that is winning the playoff final. And unfortunately, we're not going to be there. But again, I don't want it to overshadow the fact that, you know, us as a group have achieved two very big goals this year. You know, we finished third in the league, and we won the Gardner Conference. And I think, all the injuries we faced this year, and the adversity we faced. We overcame that, and we got over the line, but it's unfortunate that we're not going to be there.
Yeah, the pain will be sinking in, no doubt, until the end of next weekend. But I suppose it does give you an objective for next season in terms of getting to Nottingham. That must be in the plan for next year before you've even started.
Yeah, I think, obviously, our number one goal is going to be to retain the Gardner Conference. I think that puts us in a good position to achieve a second goal, which is getting to Nottingham. And I think, that's not going to change. I think, what drove me last year, last summer, was that we didn't make the playoffs, and we finished out of the playoffs. And, I think there's going to be a drive for me to retain that Gardner Conference and make sure that we have the best possible chance as an organization to get down to Nottingham. I know how much it means to the fans, and if it means a lot to me. I haven't been there in 4 or 5 years as a player, and it's something that is special, and it is the showpiece of the league, and I want Dundee and its fans to experience that.
And back to the season, Jeff. Where would be your highlight moments or key moments, you think, in terms of picking up that Gardner Conference title?
I think the comeback against Brayhead. I think, the game that we came back from 2 or 3 down, and we ended up winning it at home. I think that was a big turning point, especially playing against them. I think it gave us a psychological advantage, playing them for the rest of the season. I think, the other big game against Brayhead in Brayhead, when we scored shorthanded with literally a minute and a half left. I think you look back at those and you think we clinched the conference with 2 weeks to go. I think that is a major thing. That's a major part of why we clinched conference, because we came back in those two games. So I think that's a big turning point for us.
It certainly was. In terms of the players this year, you couldn't have asked much more. You must be incredibly proud of them.
Yeah, I mean, the group has been fantastic. I've been saying this all along. I think I took a lot of risks this summer. I think I took a lot of risks in some key areas, and I think especially in goaltending. And when I say risk, I'd say calculated risk. I did a lot of research on Dan Bakla. I know his numbers in pro weren't fantastic, but he was an outstanding goaltender in college. And, some people that are really close to him that know our league said he would be successful. And you know what? Those will be the same people that I'm calling this summer, for references on new guys.
Battle to keep a lot of them, I would imagine.
I think British contingent. I think we're confident that those guys will be back. I think work is well on its way to securing them. Imports is a different beast. I think my selling point to them this summer was that they would use this as a stepping stone to go on to bigger and better things. Not better in terms of the organization, but the league and what they want to accomplish in their careers. And I think Jerry Polistroni moving mid-season, we didn't plan on it, but that was off the back of a fantastic season on his part. And I don't hold any animosity towards him. I think he it's a lifetime opportunity for him. He's re-signed, which is a fantastic thing for us as a club, that we're pushing players on. And that's going to be a major part of my selling point this year, this summer, when I'm recruiting, is that, I want you to get to the next level. I know that you don't have big numbers right now. I said, but you come in, do well by us, and we'll push you on.
Uh, been really supportive of the players in terms of accommodations, etc. I mean, that must please you that you've got a good backing behind you, because some clubs haven't. That backing must help you to recruit players as well.
I mean, I've played in this league almost 10 years, and I think, you know, it's probably the classiest organization I've played for. You know, Belfast had a lot of money when I played there, you know, and they treated the players right, and they still do. But, you know, lower end budget teams, this is probably the best place that I've played, you know, in my 10 years. I think the Wards do a fantastic job at accommodating the guys, and and especially Sandy Cram at the rink, you know, they do a fantastic job at accommodating the guys. And, you know, this club runs on a lot of, you know, volunteers. And I think that, you know, everyone's so passionate about the club's success that, you know, it really, really comes across onto the players, and the players enjoy playing here. And, you know, they don't leave because they don't enjoy it here. They leave because they want to go to the next level. And I think, you know, that's always good, because when you're recruiting, people do talk. And I think that, you know, that's never a concern for me that anyone says a bad thing about Dundee.
Another plus for the league this year has been the introduction of Premier Sports. Games being on television. Do you think that helps to recruit players as well, because players might have access to seeing the games and maybe the standard of the league as well as you're talking about?
Yeah, I think it does. I think obviously, you know, Premier picking up, I think it's good, you know, with the absence of Sky. I think, you know, Sky's reach might be a little bit, you know, a little bit more than Premier Sports, but it's good that we have somebody at the moment that had taken an interest in elite league ice hockey in the UK. You know, and I think you know, Aaron Murphy, the guy that does Premier Sports, does a fantastic job, and you know, his credibility is good in the game. And you know, again, any exposure is a good exposure, and you know, hopefully that they continue to feed this relationship.
I mean, as well as that, there's no doubt that the standard in the league's increasing every single year. And that's obviously attracted larger crowds this season as well, and that must please you as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's good for business, right? You know, and you're winning. I think, you know, we've won probably 85-90% of our home games this year, which is always good. You know, a guy like Lubomir Veskovic, yeah, Lubo, he was saying to me, he's like, he didn't realize how good the standard is here. I mean, it is a high standard. You've got guys that have played in the NHL. You've got guys that have played a lot of games in the American League. There is a high standard, you know, and it's just, it's a North American style, and it probably doesn't get its credit because it is a North American style, but it is, you know, there's some good players that have passed through this league in the last 10 years. And hopefully the fans, especially in Dundee, have taken notice of the team this year, and we've succeeded on that front, bringing some silverware back. And, you know, the sellout against Fife, hopefully that, you know, that brings some people, that brought some people to the rink that haven't been here in a while, and they got that excitement again.
So, I mean, it's a massive credit to yourself and achieve.
I want the club to get better. I think there's a lot of things. I think, you know, at the end of last year, we talk about this, there was a lot of disappointment that we didn't make the playoffs, but again, it was so close. You look at the season last year, and you look, we could have won the Gardner Conference, and we didn't make the playoffs within like a week, which was, you know, it's good for the competition, but it's heartbreaking nonetheless. I think the biggest thing for me is that, you know, when I bring a player here, I want the adjustment to be minimal. I think I really want players to come in and, you know, you know, so when I try to like improve things in the locker room, and I speak to Sandy Cram, and there's like minor tweaks that we go through that might not seem like much, but it allows the players to come in, makes their adjustment time less, they are happier, they play harder, they work harder for you. And, you know, I just think that, you know, I will continue to work on that in terms of the off-ice capabilities. But again, it goes back to, you know, recruiting. I need to do my work in the summer, and, you know, I committed last summer to doing it, and I'm going to have to do the same because we've set a level here, you know, that we're trying to bring back. And obviously, again, you know, when you look at the goals for next year, obviously number one goal is to retain the Gardner Conference, and that's, you know, nothing less for me is you know, acceptable for us.
I mean, is it a concern the fans might get a bit carried away next year? Well, obviously they've had a great season, Gardner Conference champions. Concern maybe the start off went too high of an expectation, which might put a lot of pressure on yourself and the players, or does that just come with the territory?
Yeah, I mean, I think it comes to the territory. I think, you know, the positive sign for me is the last 2 years that the conference system's been in place, we've been there, thereabouts, and we've won it one of those 2 years. I think, you know, if we're in a position next year where we're in with a shout to win it, then I've done my job. I think, you know, again, I think for us, the goal every year is that we need to be a top eight team and make the playoffs. I think, you know, and again, if we want to get to Nottingham, we need to win the Gardner Conference, and then that's not going to change. I think, you know, overall standings, did we overachieve this year, and did we finish third? Yes, I think we did have a great season, and I think it will be hard to replicate that. But again, I'm not going to try any less in terms of recruiting this summer.
And just one final question on the fans this year in general, if you've got a message for them, and also for the travelling fans who go kind of week in, week out with the Stars Travel Club as well to away games, because obviously they do spend a lot of money and a lot of time as well.
Yeah. No, I mean, I always say to myself, you know, if I was a fan, I don't know if I'd put the commitment in that these fans put in. I think in terms of, you know, one, my time, and two, the money that they put in. They plow in money week in, week out, and don't think that the players for 1 minute don't appreciate that. It's always good, especially when you go into a place like Hull, which is a pretty, you know, low atmosphere, and, you know, you have more fans. It's kind of like the other night, you know, Fife had a lot of fans, and I think it really helped them and pushed them on, and I think it does make a difference. And, you know, I do understand that Dundee is a blue-collar city, and you know what? They choose to spend their budget in a certain way, and it includes us, and I'm and the ownership are forever grateful.
That's good luck for next season.
Cheers. We'll see you later.